In this video, you'll learn how to create a health bar to visually represent the health that a character has. You'll also learn how to polish the health bar so that it looks fantastic while maintaining consistency and accuracy. Howdy, welcome to Game Endeavor. Learn practical dev skills and improve the quality of your game by subscribing and ding-a-linging that bell. You now have a health system in your game, but you want to display the character's health, otherwise you could cause confusion about how much health the character actually has. Luckily, Godot has a built-in health bar source that we can take advantage of. It's the Texture Progress Control Node. And despite its name, it functions similar enough to a health bar, so we'll be using that. Let's go ahead and get started. I've created a scene with a control root that will contain our health bar. With this progress bar, there are three graphics that we can set to establish how the health bar will look. The under, which is what will be displayed beneath the health bar. The purpose of this is to show how much health the character could have if they were at max health. This is usually dark in color so as not to grab a lot of attention. There's an over texture, which is what is shown on top of the health bar. This is usually a border and is mostly transparent. Then there's the progress texture, which is what visually displays the amount of health that the character has. For this, I will be using a white texture. This is because we can also adjust the tint of the health bars, which we'll be using to tell the player how dangerously low their health is. Initially, I will set it to a green color. The health bar can be instantiated on top of a character so that it moves around with them, or on the HUD so that the player always sees it. You would typically do this for the player character. Inside of the script, we can just create a method that updates the value of our health bar. Create a method for updating the maximum health of the character, and voila, we have a health bar. Personally, I like for my games to have a little more polish to them, and this is simply not enough. One of the easiest upgrades we can make is rather than setting the value instantly, we can ease it down with using a tween. So I'll add a tween node, cache it in our script, and use it to interpolate the value property of our health bar. The interpolation will start at the current value of our health bar and end at the value passed to it in the method. Give it whatever durations and easing you would like, then start the tween and you'll see that it is a much smoother transition. However, as a game designer, this is not optimal. During the tweening, you're not showing the inaccurate representation of the player's health, so during that time, they may think that they have more health than they actually do. Suspense is wonderful in games, but this is not the place for it. And with the easing, it's not initially clear how much health the character has lost. You have to wait a little bit to know the exact impact that the damage had, and even in that fraction of a moment, it can be unclear to the player how much damage was dealt. So remove the easing, we're not going to use it. What was the point, you ask? Am I so cruel that I enjoy teasing you with the idea of using a tween and then pulling the rug out from under you? Absolutely, but that's not relevant here. Instead, we're going to place another progress bar behind our health bar, color it red, and ease it instead. What you end up with is a little red bar that shows how much damage was dealt, and you have that nice easing effect that we desire. You can also add a delay for a little more impact. Make sure to remove the under texture from the top health bar and add it to the second health bar instead. Now we need to address the color of the health bar. It's always green, meaning that no matter how crippled your character is, that happy little green bar is always going to be sunshine and rainbows. How about we rain on its parade? Before doing this, let's pick the colors for each of the states. I'm going to store these in export variables so that we can adjust them externally. I will create a healthy color export variable to store what color the health bar should be when it has plenty of health. We'll give it the color hint so that you can customize it in the inspector, and I will default it to color.green. A caution color export variable for when the player should be a little more concerned. It has a color hint as well and will default to color.yellow. And then we'll create a danger color export variable, which as you guessed has the color hint and will default to color.red. We also want to know when these different colors take effect, so we'll create an export variable with a float hint from 0 to 1 with a step of 0.05. I'll name this variable caution zone and default it to 0.5. This will determine at what percentage of health is considered cautious and will turn the health bar yellow. We'll then create another variable just like this one, except we'll name it danger zone and default it to 0.2. Now to keep things nice and tidy, I'm going to create a function named assignColor and call it in our onHealthUpdated method, passing to it the health variable. In this method, we're going to check and see what the health variable is and decide what color our health bar should be. We will do this in reverse order, checking if health is in the danger zone by saying if health is less than health over dot max value times danger zone, which checks to see if health is less than the percentage that we have specified as dangerous. Then we'll set our health over dot temp progress equal to danger color, which will set it red. After this, we'll check to see if health is in the cautious zone by checking if health is less than health over dot max value times cautious zone. If so, then we'll set health over dot temp progress equal to caution color. And if none of these are true, then we'll say else health over dot temp progress equals healthy color, which will set it to our happy-go-lucky green color. This works fine and all, but there's always more to polish. I imagine you've played games where the health bar will pulse when your character's health is low. Maybe even play a soft soothing sound quietly in the background. How about we implement this for ourselves? To do this, we're going to create another tween named PulseTween, making sure to enable repeat. And then we'll go ahead and do my favorite part of creating any node. You know what I'm talking about. We also want to set what color we're going to pulse to, so I'll create an export variable named PulseColor, giving to it the color hint and defaulting it to color.darkRed. We may want our health bar to pulse for the player, but not necessarily for the enemies. So we're going to create another export variable named willPulse, this time giving to it the bool hint and defaulting it to false. So back when we check the danger zone, we will add a condition to check if willPulse is true. If so, then we're going to interpolate the property so that it eases. For this particular effect, I want the health to instantly turn deep red and then slowly fade back to normal. What you get is a nice pulsing effect, almost like how your head feels when you have a pounding headache. So we're going to pass this method in our health over node, the temp progress property, and then pulse color as the initial value, and it will ease back to the danger color. I'll give it a duration of 1.2 seconds, and then use the basic sine transition with an in-out easing. Then we want to start the tween. As for the sound when pulsing, we're going to need an audio stream player. However, you're only going to want to play this sound for the player. At least, I really hope that's your intention. So it would be a waste to add an audio stream player for every enemy with a health bar if we're not going to use it. So I suggest emitting a signal that the player can connect to and play the sound there. You can't just emit the signal here though, because this code is only going to be called once per every time the character's health updates. We want to emit the signal repeatedly with the pulsing. For that, we can use the tween's interpolate callback method, which will call a method of our choosing every time the tween runs. Our tween repeats, so it will happen once every 1.2 seconds. We will pass through the method self, which is the object that has the property, 0.0, since we want the sound to play immediately with the pulse. The string value emits signal, and then the signal that we want to emit, which I will call pulse, and define it at the top of the script. Now just connect the signal to your character and play the sound there. We've got our pulse playing, however it will start immediately whenever we take damage and our health is critical. If it's already playing, then we don't want it to interrupt itself by starting over, so we'll add an if condition checking if pulse tween is not active before starting the pulse. Now we also need to disable the pulsing should we regain enough health so that we're no longer critical. However, an odd little quirk that I found is that if you stop a repeating tween and then start it again, it will no longer repeat. We can get around this by instead calling pulseTween.setActive false, which will do before setting a non-critical color. Between you and me, I kind of like this method though, because it allows us to check to see if a tween is running, whichever the sneaky sneak I did previously before starting the pulse. Should your character die and you squint really hard, you might notice a tiny bit of pulsing in the health bar. So we're going to check to see if health is equal to zero. If so, then we'll call the setActive false again to disable it. Now, surely this is good, right? Nope. Let's really let the player know if damage has been dealt. If amount is less than zero, then we'll call the method flashDamage, which we'll define shortly. Before we start flashing, we're going to need to know a few things first. We want to know how quickly the flashing is going to occur, which I will define as a constant named flashRate and set it to 0.05 seconds. We also want to know how many times it is going to flash, which I will define as n flashes and set it to 4. And then, we want to be able to set the flash color, so I will create an export variable named flashColor, giving to it the color hint and defaulting it to color.orangeRed. We're also going to need another tween. If there's one thing you can say about this channel, it's that my viewers are going to have a firm grasp on how to masterfully wield a tween. I think I'll call them tweengineers. But this one is interesting because we're actually not going to use it to do any easing. We'll go in to find our flash damage function, and we'll create a for loop since we want the flashing to occur multiple times. We'll say for I in range in flashes times 2. We're multiplying by 2 because we're going to be taking a super cheeky approach to setting the color. We'll say var color equals health over dot temp progress. If I modulus 2 equals 1, else flash color. Like I said, pretty cheeky. What this does is set our color to flash for every even iteration. For every odd iteration, it will flash its current color. 0 to 7, that's 4 flashes with 2 alternating colors. We'll also want to determine the time for each flash, which we'll store in a variable named time and set it equal to flash rate times I plus flash rate, which will increase time by flash rate every iteration, and since we're starting with the flash color, we'll offset it by the flash rate. We'll then call the FlashTween's interpolate callback method, passing to it health over as the node, time as the duration. We're going to use the set method for setting the property, since we'll be using it in the tween callback. We need to pass to it the string value of the property we want to set, which is temp progress, and then we'll pass to it our color variable. Once our loop is finished, we want to start the tween so that it runs all of the callbacks we just set up. Another tweak we can use to really add a punch to the health bar is some shaking. While working on a collaboration project with PigDev, Mzzzzzzzzzzzzzz and Ryan Fleury, which you'll hear more about soon, I rejiggered my camera shake code into a utility node so that it can shake any numerical value passed to it. Adding that to the health bar adds a satisfying effect. To learn how I do the shaking, watch my first video on Screenshake, and if you're new, then join the sub club to get notified for future videos.